music. I got all these questions for you, but I kind of want to listen to just one, see if I can find one more piece of like live music, especially like a live video. Because I literally, like I told you, I downloaded maybe 130 different either albums or songs just for today.
My long music I got here hooked up is on my scooter dang for this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I could play it, I guess, but it went, I don't know. But we weren't prepared for it. My scooter's back there.
Oh, this is kind of sweet. Speaking of Pennies from Heaven, see if you can name. This is Pennies from Heaven. Can you name the singer? This is from either 1936 or 1937.
Sound like a little, I'm sorry, kind of.
Well, the singer.
I'm saying. That music is called something that, yeah, like.
Maybe, but maybe. This is from 1936,
wait,
though.
Wait a minute. No, that's Prez.
Yes, sir.
And David Fred on the sax, huh?
Maybe. This is 1936 or 1937, this recording.
Yeah, but she's the one named the president.
Oh, that's right. That's she, right. Yeah, who else would, yeah.
She's the one who named him. That's why I said sound like Fred.
You know your players.
I thought it was Coleman Hawkins.
You know your players.
Trade them for fortune of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There be pennies from heaven for you and for me. Doop 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 from heaven. When you want the thing you love, pennies from heaven. You find your fortune falling all over town. Hey. I forgot I was on TV. Man. Billie Holiday. And she, hey, man, she was something else, man. Yeah.
No. Oh, here's another person you know.
See if it recognizes the player.
Is that Lockjaw Davis?
Yes, sir. You got an ear. You've got an ear. Man, you got an ear on you, Lee.
Kind of confused me every minute.
Because we just listened to him, yeah. It's kind of a...
Yeah,
man,
but he's in a different groove.
The,
you know,
golden, the golden ear of Lee Kennedy.
You got to listen to it. That's why he got his old fingerprint. And his sound ain't going to sound like that. Something close to him, but that's why... That's Shirley Scott on.
Now, did you meet Eddie Lockjaw Davis?
Mm-mm.
Or Shirley Scott? Because they're before your time.
No, it wasn't before my time. It's just that they didn't come in town.
Oh, okay.
You know, if they come in town, they would, somebody else, but they didn't come in with anybody. You
Detroit
know?
Was too small time for them?
Yeah, well, nobody had no money in Detroit. Detroit was poor when I came here. It was ghetto when I came here.
Yeah.
And, you know, people, think about it in 68, man. They had soup line. In fact, I had left on my way here. My aunt told me, said I could come and stay with them when I saved my money and put my stuff in storage. And we got rented a trailer. On our way here, my aunt called Arkansas, but I had already left to tell me I shouldn't come because it's too bad. I don't know what I'm. We ain't got no room for him, and it hurt me so damn bad. Okay, but we were all the way on our way up. So when I got here, I went to my sister and brother-in-law house, and I told him like this one. I just told him I just how much did you rent. I pay hay.
Man.
Okay. And they had an extra bedroom. So my nephew was small, about 3 or 4 years old, something like that, 5. So we had a living room, but, you know, so we took his bedroom, and I think they fixed him up in the living room. And that's what I did, but I was only there for 6 months, and I got my apartment. The first holiday came for the weekend. I got in January, and just think the first holiday came for a weekend. And that's I took off and went down and picked up my stuff and came back and got my own apartment.
Man.
You know, and so, and then I got my first cousin a job with me. But I'm just saying, people, I've been hurt a lot.
And you gave your brother a job, and you gave countless relatives down the line a job.
I get a couple.
Well, a bunch.
Of them,
well,
a couple, you
number
know,
of them.
Know, you know,
not but, all of them, but a number
yeah,
of them.
Yeah, a couple people.
You're right. Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And yeah, but I'm just still sad. But the people are, but they hurt me. But I'm just still sad. But nobody knew. They always had negative things to say because whatever my dream was different from the rest of the people. I was trying to be different anyway. You understand? Well, not trying to be. Yeah, I was trying to be different because I didn't want to be that. Like I want, because I said I would never get married. I had to take care of a family. Like that.
Oh.
And my mother used to tell me, I bet you I'm going to marry somebody's going to be ugly and stuff like that. She's going to be nasty.
Man.
She's just teasing me, you know.
Oh, okay.
Stuff. Well, anyway, I don't know. She was just teasing me. Okay. And stuff. When I brought her here and told her she was very proud of what I've done, what I've seen.
Good.
You know. And
rightfully so. I mean, look at you.
But, when she would always tell me, you always gonna be anything. I'm gonna be, you know, the parents do that to you. You ain't gonna be nothing. All that kind of thing. You're gonna be like your daddy. He ain't gonna be nothing. All that kind of shit, you know. But that.
Don't I know it?
Yeah, you know. If they do that, and hey. And I can understand it now because my ex is, they tell my kids, you just like your daddy.
Yeah.
When they married with him, you did where I'm coming from, that's not fair. When you do something bad, you're like your daddy. You did. And they grew up with it, but people are always teaching hate.
Yeah, I agree that it's quite a rude thing to turn the worst thing in the world into, you know, the father of your kids, you know, turn that into an
I never divorced my kids. I said it. I never divorced. I always fought all my wives.
Yeah.
I always fought them, but, you know.
I have another version of Pennies from Heaven. See if you can name that singer.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that used to be my song, man. Pennies from Heaven. Moody Mood for Love.
Yes, sir.
Penny from heaven. Say it. Penny from heaven.
Ooh.
Yeah. All the time. Your umbrella upside down.
Trade them for
fortune, sunshine, brown.
If you want the things you love, you must have showers.
Yeah.
Yes,
I know. Don't run out of trees. Plenty of heaven from you and me. Deep, 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 deep.
Hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. The piano player ain't saying nothing. What she's saying is,
right, doing his own version of events. Yeah.
He just put that in. Yeah. Over time. Upside down. Sunshine,
flowers. If you want the things you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder down, run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you.
Yeah. I saw it Ford Auditorium.
Who, you saw her live?
Yeah, Sarah Vaughan's Ford Auditorium.
Did you get to meet her?
No, I didn't get to meet her. Man, she is something. But she sweats perspire when she sings, man. She does a lot of coke, they always said, there's rumor. And her nose, man, her nose was just as clean, no hairs on her nose at all, man. I was sitting right up under her, you know, I could. She's something else, man. And she was sweating, the coat was running, but she's something else.
This is probably one of the original versions of it. From Eddy Duchin, or Duchin, and his orchestra. Vocal refrain by Lou Sherwood. From the Columbia film Pennies from Heaven.
Now you see how they sang it, Blaine? See? It's a different Eddy. So you got to know how to read the music of that.
Yeah, I can't read music. I can read chords, I guess, but...
I can't read none of it.
Right.
I wish I could, man.
Yes. Wish I knew a lot more.
Pennies from heaven. Now, they did something to this song, didn't they? I mean, I'm just saying, wait, we jazzed it up.
Yeah, this is not as...
Compared to that?
Right.
That was old in the old days. But he just liked the song. Be sure that your umbrella upside down. And that's what they did. Take them old songs and bring them alive.
Dust them off and... Yeah.
But Eddie Jeff and that kind of singing. Lambert Henry Ross, man.
People watching, we need to get some power, some money, some whatever it takes. We need an album of standards sung by Lee Kennedy. One track would be My Way, Lee's Way. One track would be Old Folks, the Charlie Parker, but Lee's Way. Maybe
you
we could
got
do
a lot of comedies. I mean.
maybe Pennies from Heaven or Benny's from Heaven is even funnier. Both, yeah, you know, yeah. We could do one and the other.
Benny's from Heaven, yeah.
We gotta get a track list
here.
I
thought that was so cool when he came out there. He got a lot of things out, man. Filthy Mike Nasty, he wrote a tune. He write a lot of tunes like that, you know.
Yeah.
He never got played. In fact, he probably got bigger after he died than he was then.
Speaking of songwriters, last time we got together and listened to albums, we listened to Lambert Hendricks and Ross, the hottest new group in jazz, 1959. So many great songs off that. The black gentleman in the band, John Hendricks, I didn't know this was a songwriter, wrote a bunch of songs for James Moody or whoever it was. And Al Jarreau called him pound for pound the best jazz singer perhaps of all time.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Well, Al Jarreau, he came on the scene. You know, I never got into Al Jarreau, but he was, he so good, but he sang, he had a different way of singing.
Yeah.
But I never got into Al Jarreau. I couldn't hear everybody, you know, he had to be exception, I guess. I don't know. But he never knocked me out.
All right. Here's another lady singer. I just want to see if you can identify the singer just by ear. This is from 1946.
I get it. We're back there. That's a kid.
No, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
No. I didn't really think it was, but wait a minute. I don't. I don't know who that is, really. It's not young for sure. Diana Washington?
Yes, sir.
You know, I kind of should. Was on my mind, but it don't sound like her. That's
it was from 1946, probably. Maybe yeah. She was younger.
I just look at the name, Blue Gardenia. I never heard of the album, either.
Yeah, it's from 1946, so you were like a teenager.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I was born then.
34, yeah. Or yeah, you're... All right, now let's just do a couple more songs, and I got some questions.
When Greg got hip to Diane Washington, she sang something about, what was that song? She came in for an auditorium.
Dinah?
Yeah. And she was late getting that. That's why they didn't want to book us today in the first place.
Day late and a dollar short.
So, booked her there, and Dinah was late getting there, and there was a white guy in the audience. Started hecking her, and she walked up on stage. She says, "Will you please shut your homosexual mouth?" And I just started. It was in the free press.
Yeah. That's great.
Isn't it crazy, man? Shut your homosexual mouth. That was what it was in.
Right, that you could say something like that, yeah.
Yeah, but she was. Well, she did that.
By her own drum. Went by her own drum.
Yeah. And, you know, they didn't have many things there that I can remember from. They had Berry Gordy, Dinah Ross was there. And
at the Ford Auditorium.
Yeah, Ford Auditorium. And I think they had Luther Vandross come in there. Yeah, because I took that girl, I was telling you about, I was doing, because she the one got me with Luther Vandross. And she would love him, you know. And,
man.
But anyway, I went to see him there.
I'm going to see if you can recognize this person. You probably will. Okay. The person hasn't sung yet. The singer hasn't started singing yet.
Who? Oh.
I hope they sing. Hope it's not just a choir the whole time. It's supposed to be C.L. Franklin. Because our most popular video is a C.L. Franklin one. So this is a C.L. Franklin's, I guess, choir singing.
Oh, I wouldn't know.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be him, but it's just his choir.
Oh, I wouldn't know Franklin himself. He had a special voice. Oh, everybody would know Franklin. He had his, like James Brown. You know James Brown, anybody. You
very
know?
Particular, yeah.
Uh-huh.